Okay, so what is up guys? Now Frustraeder is back at it again with another Bitcoin update. As always, every day except this last weekend. Bakit? Kasi I was away from the house. No, medyo gumalagala tayo sa Sky Ranch Tagaytay. And today is July 11, 2022, 5:10 PM. No? So balik na tayo sa ating regular daily updates. Okay, so gusto nyo ba simulan na natin? So siguro pwede na natin simulan. No? So currently, we are here on the hourly time frame ni BTC. No, so ano yung nakikita natin dito? So siguro ito pwede ko nang burahin para luminis ng konti yung chart. Ayan, pwede ko na silang burahin. Ayan. So currently, we are still monitoring this potential bearish expanding triangle. So alin yun dito sa chart? Ang dami namang guhit dyan sa edge. Alin yun dyan? So this is its resistance. And this one is its support or the patterns support and resistance areas, no? So ano yung target natin? Sabi natin if this is going to break down at this point, this would target here 18.5k. Since hindi siya diyan nag-breakdown, hindi siya nagkaroon ng breakdown point diyan, so di ba dito ganito natin kinuha yung kanyang target. Since dito siya nag-break ng support, ayun yung kanyang breakdown point, doon natin ilalagay yung ating potential target. So this is now going to target at around the 18.7, 18.8 or let's say 19k area, no, for ano lang, para i-round off na natin. So yun yung kanyang potential scenario. Since nagkaroon na dito ng breakdown, alam natin or lagi nating hinahanap during a breakdown is either a increase in selling pressure or a volume spike. So hindi natin yan masyado nakita dito, although may increase dito, 'di ba? May increase naman siya, obviously dito meron siya increase, but hindi siya ganoon ka ano, obvious. So ano yung potential scenario dito? Since nag-breakdown siya dito or na-break niya yung ating support area, so potentially pwede niya itong i-retest yung area na yan. Let's say pwede yung umabot dito around the 21k area, or pwede rin na hanggang dito lang sa 1 hour EMA 200 or either dito sa 1 hour EMA 20. So that is a possible rejection area. So for me, no? So yun lang siguro for the 1 hour time frame. Those are the scenarios that I am looking for, 'di ba? So lipat na tayo sa 4 hour time frame. So sa 4 hour time frame, 'di ba, kita natin yan dito. Sabi natin this is a good area for retest, yung 1 hour EMA 200 or this one, this area, tama, 1 hour EMA 200. Kasi dito sa 4 hour time frame, that is the 4 hour EMA 50. And again, based ating recent price action, alam na natin kung gaano ka-significant si 4 hour EMA 50, right? So, kung alam natin nyo, so potentially, since hindi nga nagkaroon ng matinding selling pressure during the breakdown ni 4 hour EMA 50, pwede niyang i-retest yan, and eventually, or if it is going to reject the price action, pwede yang biglang magkaroon ng matinding reaction for it to hit the target, which is around the 19k-ish area. Okay? So, for that is good. Okay? So, zoom out tayo ng konti para lumaki yung ating, ano, kumbaga, point of view. So, diba, sabi natin, we are seeing this potential rising wedge pattern, diba? So, currently, it is right now testing, or Bitcoin is right now testing its support area. So, if ever that the price action is going to test the 4-hour EMA 50 here and eventually getting a good rejection, potentially, this would target to the bottom part of the wedge, which is in this case, this could be the target one, and then the aggressive target would be around the 17.6k-ish area, since that is the actual bottom of the wedge. Okay, so those are my targets. So bakit yan posibleng mangyari? Ano yung bakit may ascending triangle dito, diba? Diniscuss natin yung sa ating last video, sa latest video. So diba, I think I have sent a tweet. So ito buksan natin, this is my tweet, diba? Last January to April, I think nag-form siya nitong ascending triangle and nagkaroon siya ng rising wedge inside that. So dito, it looks like it broke out as an ascending triangle, but it became a fake out, and then eventually it broke down as this rising wedge pattern. So boom, boom, boom. Then dito, gumawa ulit siya around May to June, gumawa ulit siya nitong ating ascending triangle again, which is again a bullish pattern. Nagkaroon ulit ng fake out, dalawa. The same dito, dalawa, di ba? Nagka-fake out. And then, nag-form siya ng rising wedge pattern. And eventually, it broke down again. Instead of breaking out as a ascending triangle. So, dito, di ba? This was sent, I think, July 9, ito. Before I stepped out of the house, di ba? So, dito, nagkaroon na siya ng unang fake out. I think, pwede nyo to consider as the first fake out. Kasi, nagkaroon siya ng wick up sa labas na ating resistance ascending triangle. So, If this is again an ascending triangle na nag-fake out and turns to be a potential rising wedge, which is again, ito siya, diba? Yan yung sa actual chart ko. Diba? So, potentially, pwede siya magkaroon ulit ng downtrending scenario. But again, pwede yung ma-invalidate lahat. Diba? Nothing is guaranteed here in the market or in anything, no? Walang guaranteed sa buhay. Dapat alam natin yan. Diba? So, yun lang. Again, that is still my bias. I'm still on a short position dito kay Bing X. And again, guys, kung gusto nyo subukan mag-trade or mag-start mag-invest sa cryptocurrencies with Bing X, I suggest you start doing it here kasi dito, napakababa ng ating mga transaction fees. No? Halos hindi nyo na mararamdaman. No? And again, guys, if you're an experienced trader, gusto nyo mag-trade with leverage, no? Pwede dito. Hindi lang sa crypto, kundi pati sa commodities and forex. Let's say naman you're a busy person, gusto mo magkaroon ng potential passive income, pwede mong subukan si copy trade feature ni Bing X. And let's say you are from commodities or forex or US market or PSEI, gusto mo matutunan kung ano nga ba si cryptocurrency, ano si blockchain and other things na nandito sa ating cryptocurrency space, pwede ka dito mag-aral kay Bing X Academy for free. Diba? Libre lahat yan ibibigay sa'yo at ituturo sa'yo ni Bing X Academy. At kung gusto nyo gumawa ng account, kung wala pa kayong account, diba? Pwede kayong gumawa na dyan sa ating description yung registration link. Scroll down lang kayo, pindutin nyo yung red na button and then scroll down ng konti, pindutin nyo yung see more, makikita nyo lahat ng link na hahanapin nyo. Diba? So, yun na lang siguro. And then, this is our daily time frame. Diba? So, dito sa ating daily time frame, no? Sabi natin, this looks like a symmetrical triangle. So, ito, pwede ko na siguro itong alisin. This is going to be invalidated. This one as well. Diba? So, that is for the bearish pennant. So, those are invalidated na. Ito, alisin ko na din para luminis yung chart. So, diba? If this is our symmetrical triangle, this is its resistance and this is its support. Okay? So, if nag-breakout siya dito, wala tayong nakitang buying pressure. So, potentially, pwede ba siya mag-retest dito around this retest niya itong recent resistance to confirm it as a new support? Pwede. That is a possible scenario. Pwede siya magkaroon ngayon dyan ng bounce and eventually hit around the 25.2K-ish area na target niya. But, diba? If that is to happen, gusto natin makita na syempre, again, ng increasing volume. So, again, kinuha natin ito, recent high to recent swing low na Fibonacci levels. So, itong 0.382 area is confluent with the bottom part of this support and resistance box na ginawa natin from a long, long time ago. And again, the 0.382 area is a significant level. Why? Kasi yan yung opposite ni 0.618. So, if the price action is going to get rejected here, which is, it looks like what is happening right now, potentially, pwede ito magtuloy-tuloy pababa. That is just my opinion. So, siguro, next yung tanong. So, Edge, ano naman yung magsusupport dyan? Valid pa ba yung sinasabi mo na hidden bearish divergence na pinagsasabi mo na sobrang bias mo kasi asar na ako sa'yo? Diba? So, ito yung sagot doon. So, for me, this is still valid. Kasi kung titignan nyo, this one is still a high and this is potentially a lower high. And then, yung katapat nito, nasan yung tapat nyan? This is a high, actually. And yung part na yan, and then this is still a higher high. So, that is still a hidden bearish divergence, which is, nagpo-form siya ng lower high sa price action, and then higher high sa RSI. So, potentially, this is going to be its trigger, kasi na-rejection EMA20, diba? It barely closed, or it did not have a solid candle body. Gusto natin makakita ng ganitong formation ng kandila above this. Pero anong nangyari above the EMA 20 is meron siyang dalawang doji candles, which is again, they are rejection candles. Diba? So, alam nyo na naman siguro yan. Those are parts of the basics. No? So, if that is going to happen, again, this is still my bias. No? It doesn't have to be yours. It's just mine. This is not a financial advice. Okay? Anything can happen. Pwede ito ma-invalidate. No, yun lang. Tandaan nyo lang yun. Diba? So, dito naman tayo sa ating weekly time frame. Zooming out sa ating weekly time frame. Ayan, di ba? Makita natin, this is a falling wedge pattern. Again, falling wedge pattern is a bullish pattern. But again, hindi naman dahil bullish pattern is 100% it is always going to break out. There's still a chance for it to break down, lalo na kung talaga malakas yung selling pressure. Kasing lakas nung tambutso ng lumampas na motor. Di ba? So, anong nangyari dito sa ating falling wedge pattern, it broke down as a bearish breakdown. So, again, the target for this pattern is around the 16,150 or 16.2, 16K-ish area around that area. So again, that is a target. Okay, this is the yellow box from the daily time frame. It looks like it is retested here on the weekly time frame, and it has been rejecting the price action, di ba? So sa recent weekly candle natin, since it has closed earlier today around 8 a.m. so di ba, nag-close siya kanina, but again it closed below the candle body of this one. Ibig sabihin, that is a rejection candle, lalo na meron pa tayo nakitang ganitong week sa taas. So that is a strong rejection in my very honest opinion, and potentially this is going to be leading to a more downside price action. In my honest opinion lang naman, di ba? Kasi if this is to recover, gusto natin makita siya mag-close above this, above the 22K area, if this is going to be a strong recovery. So may napansin ako dito ngayon lang, no? So kasi nga, hindi ako nag-script kapag gumagawa ng videos. So yan, this could be a potential resistance area. Pwede ito, let's say, pwede yan maging support area. So siguro, ayusin ko ng papaganito. Diba? Pwede, diba? That is the support and resistance area. Potentially, this could be a potential bear flag pattern. So, if this is going to be a bear flag pattern, kunin natin conservatively yung target niya. Saan ba siya posibleng umabot? Bakit nga ba magiging ano siya? Breakdown, what could be the potential breakdown target dito? Let's say, this is the top of the pole. Diba? So, this is the bottom of the pole. So, yan, hilahin lang natin. Lagay natin sa potential breakdown point. Let's say, dito siya mag-breakdown sa current weekly candle, no? Potentially, this is going to target at around the 12.8K-ish area. So, pwede ko yung gawin. O, platan ko yan dito. Diba? This is the weekly time frame. So, ayan, around the 12.8K area. So, potentially, pwede mangyari. But again, if this is going to breakdown, gusto natin makita ng matinding selling pressure. Diba? Napakarami na nating confluences to each other. So, tingnan natin sa mga susunod na galaw natin mga kandila. Lipat muna tayo dito kay Bitcoin dominance. So, di ba, sabi natin, this could be a potential double bottom pattern, which is, in this case, this is going to be its neckline. So, if this is going to be a double bottom pattern here on the Bitcoin dominance's daily time frame, di ba, pwedeng-pwede yung gumawa or kunin natin yung target niya by doing this. Ayan. So, let's say, dito siya, kailangan niya mabreak tong area na to. So, target to around the 45% of Bitcoin dominance. No, so let's say naman that this is not just a simple double bottom pattern, kasi potentially pwede pa rin ito maging inverted head and shoulders, di ba? Let's say ito yung kanyang resistance area, di ba? The neckline. So potentially pwede ito maging shoulder head, and then potentially it is forming the last shoulder. If this is going to confirm, or this Bitcoin dominance action is going to bounce from this support and resistance area ng ating double bottom, pwede mag-form ng last shoulder and eventually break out. Lalaki yung chance niya or probability niya for a breakout. So, if that is to happen, kunin natin yung target niya by doing this conservatively for an inverted head and shoulders target. No, so, this is going to be its neckline. So, this is going to target at around the 45.6% of Bitcoin dominance. So, if that is the case, potentially, Bitcoin is going to make a very drastic move, or mabilis na move, no? Matinding move supported by the volume sa Bitcoin US dollar chart dito. Siguro sa daily, pwede tayo mag-base dyan. So, that is the Bitcoin dominance. Punta naman tayo ngayon kay DXY. So, DXY, again, nag-breakout siya dito sa ating cup and handle pattern. The target would be around 109.45, actually, or technically. So, sabi natin, dito sa area na to, pwede siyang ma-reject, since dito is support siya, na-break, nag-reject, and then dito, it is currently testing. So, dito, nagpapakita siya ng rejection dito sa recent week, daily candle natin. Since na-reject siya, alam nyo, kita niya natin yung malaking wick sa taas ng pulang kandila na to, right? So, if this current candle is going to close like this, this is going to be considered as a bullish engulfing candle. Pwede rin itong matreat as a potential, nawawala yung ating line, so potential bull flag pattern. So, if that is going to break out as a bull flag pattern, potentially, this would target to the target of this cup and handle as well. So, that is going to target around the 109.45 area. So, if that is going to happen, if DXY is going to break out as a bull flag pattern, potentially, tataas si DXY. Siyempre, magkakaroon siya ng breakout. So, if that is to happen, Bitcoin could be going down or continuing down, in my honest opinion. If that is going to happen, katulad ng sabi natin kanina, Bitcoin dominance could very well make a potential or good probability of a bounce and eventually break out as a tinatawag natin na inverted head and shoulders, yung pinakita natin kanina, right? So that is the possible scenario in my honest opinion. Still very much on track pa naman tayo. So bonus chart, kasi nagstay ka na dito kahit 15 minutes na yung ating video, di ba? So this is the CME chart, di ba? This is on the 1 hour time frame. So sa recent ano natin, last week, eh, nagkaroon tayo ng panibagong CME gap, which is right around this area, around the 21,750 and the 21K area. So that is a gap. So for the bullish case scenario, very very short term lang, pwede niyang i-fill yung 21 hanggang 21,750 and eventually become a, pwede yan maging ganito yung price action niya para ma-fill niya yung CME gap and then eventually continue down. Diba? Kasi if we are going to zoom out, no, napakarami pa rin or mas marami pa rin yung CME gap na hindi pa filled sa baba. And gusto natin or my bias for a very long time is for it to fill muna yung mga gap sa ibaba. Kasi mas gusto natin na umangat ng hanggang 100K si Bitcoin nang wala tayong inaalala na babalikan na gap below 3.5K, di ba? Gusto natin na kapag tumaas yan, solid na solid. So that is my, again, that is just for me, no? So ito pa lang ating CME gap na to is, I think, pwede na natin sabihin na this is already filled, ano? Filled na ba? Tingnan natin. Hindi pa siya totally filled, no? Meron pa siya maliit na gap. So, semi-filled pa lang siya. Gawin natin itong puti. No? So, gawin ko na siyang puti kasi semi-filled na eh. Diba? Yan yung ating codes dito. So, tingnan natin yung mga susunod na kabanata dito sa ating ano CME gap. So, yun lang siguro for today's video. No? Kung umabot ko sa part ng video na to, eh, i-comment mo dyan na, uy, so age is back. No? So, as always, secure your profits and protect your capital. Cut losses without mercy. I hope you guys enjoyed your weekend because I very well enjoyed mine. No, so yun lang everyone, let's go. Happy trading, happy learning.